What's up, guys? I know it's been a while. Probably about a couple months, maybe it feels like. It was like a couple months since I've done any updates to the Corvette. But things are getting a lot closer to doing my first track day. I have finally bought one, which I'll talk about later on in the video. But today, basically, I wanted to talk about everything I've been doing to the Corvette since the last videos. And I also wanted to update on what I still needed to do to the car before track day. So let's talk about what I've gotten for the car for the track day. The first thing is something that I found a killer fucking deal on. And there they are right there. Bridgestone RE11s with one track day. On some OEM size 2006 Corvette wheels. You can tell they're the same as those ones over there. Just different color, right? Because I plastic dipped them. So these things have one track day on them. They really don't look used at all. You can tell they were at a track day, but they do not look abused by any means. So I picked up a set of track wheels, already mounted and balanced, obviously, with good tires, $650. The tires alone are like $1,050 off Tire Rack, and then you have to still pay for shipping. So, you know, that's another at least $80. So you're talking a little over $1,100, plus I'd still have to get them mounted too, which I was gonna do to these wheels. But now I have a track set. They're not the sizes that I want in particular. I kind of wanted to go up from like a 245 in the front to maybe like a 275 in the front. But for the deal, I can't fucking complain. I got an awesome deal. I'm super stoked that I got some nice track tires and some track wheels for a fucking hell of a deal. Second thing that I've bought, rotors. Ended up going with Centric high carbon rotors. They're just like the step up from the cheapest ones that they had. I didn't go with the Napa or AutoZone ones. I don't know, I just didn't. I went with those. They were like a little less than $300 for all four. And we'll see how they'll hold up. I'd imagine they're gonna do pretty good considering I have brake ducting straight up from the fog lights, which a lot of you guys know. Wham bam, right there. So I think that'll help out quite a bit. So let's talk about the track day, because I bought that already now too. I'm doing Thunderhill West, September 25th. It's not necessarily the one that I wanted to do. But at the end of the day, I'm not going to complain. Like, I'm still going to be doing a track day. But the price was right. It was $150 for, I think, like, you know, 5 20-minute sessions or whatever. And it's a lot curvier of a track. There's a lot of curves in it. And it's not like, it doesn't seem like a very fast track. You know, there's no, like, really long straightaways. I watched a couple, like, Corvette videos on it. And they were getting up to, like, just a little over 100 on the straight. So it's not like a super fast track, but the price was right, $150, kind of hard to beat that. So that has already been bought. September 25th, Thunderhill West. If you guys want to come out, if I have extra room in my car, because I do have a friend and my aunt wanted to come out for my first track day. Actually, my friend that normally drives S2000, I know you guys have seen that before. But anyways, yeah, I got two people coming out. If I have extra room, I have no problem letting someone jump in the passenger seat, obviously as long as you have a helmet, and go for a drive. Or even better, if you guys wanted to bring your own car and do a track day with me too, the more the merrier. Especially for the deal, $150, right? So things that I still need to do to the car. I need to buy pads. I'm gonna buy Raybestos, how the fuck you say it. ST43, they're just straight up brace pad, because I'm going to put those rotors and the pads on it, and those will just be for the track, and then I'll swap back out
to my daily driving set right here. Same with the wheels and tires too, right? Same concept. So besides the pads, I also need to buy a couple more hose clamps so that I can actually hook up the brake ducting. And what else? I'm probably gonna get an alignment done too. I'm sitting at like 1 point. I'm gonna set it a little bit more aggressive since the Corvette's not really my daily driver. I'll probably go for about like 1.5 in the front and maybe like 0.7 in the rear. Right now the rear is sitting at like an even 0 degrees camber. And so I'm going off some settings from PFAD to some shit like that, right? Some performance driving settings for track days with street tires. So that's what I'm gonna do. So the car's pretty much done. I've changed all the fluids in this previously besides the oil. But before I do a track day, I'm gonna change the oil one last time. And then I'm also going to flush the brake fluid with some, I got some Motul RBF 600, and then I got some Amsoil brake fluid as well. So I used this for my motorcycle when I did the track day. I'm just gonna use all this up, and then from there I'll just switch to Amsoil, since you guys know I'm an Amsoil guy. It's all my dirt bike oil. And then this will be the oil that I'm putting in the vet. So yeah guys, that's really it. September 21st. Oh no, one more thing. Check this out. I got this the other day. And there's a lot of people that like have those things on the windshields that... Did I not fucking grab my keys? Oh, not my keys. One sec. So the last thing, and this seems like it's kind of... So the last thing that I did was, I was at my aunt's house the other day and she showed me this sweet little thing right there, right? It's just like a little, it's metal. And then you got this on the back of your phone. I just put on my phone case, right? So that's just gonna sit right there. I bought a 6-inch extension or a like phone charger, right? Pops in right there. And so I'll be able to, let's see. I got a lap timer, race chrono. It was free 99, baby. Free 99. And so basically, now I'll be able to track all my lap times while I'm at the track. And it was free. There's a $20 version. And from what I understood, like you can use some Bluetooth settings for the OBD2 plug. And you can like overlay like RPMs and miles per hour and shit on my GoPro video. I'm not worried about that right now, but I think, dude, for free 99, it's gonna be a sweet setup right here. Hopefully this will be like somewhat about the camera angle. And then I'll have this. And I went out for a drive last night because I just got this stuff yesterday and it holds up pretty well, even with hard driving. But obviously track day is gonna put way more stress, so hopefully it works. So that's the last thing. I'm pretty stoked about that. So yeah, guys. T-minus... What's the date today? What the fuck is the date? 23rd. So, a month and 2 days. First fucking track day. Super fucking stoked. Hit me guys up, or... So yeah, that's gonna be it. We got a month and 2 days till the last... So again, 1 month, 2 days, September 25th for the first track day for the fucking vet. I'm gonna beat the shit out of this car. You guys know what I've done to it so far. I wasn't playing any games for this car as far as reliability. So I'm gonna beat the fuck out of this car. Can't fucking wait. Super stoked. September 25th. Let me know in the comment section if any of you plan on going. I've gone to a couple track days before and just spectated. A lot of fun. Like I said, if I have room for anyone, I have more than welcome to give you a fucking a ride on the track in this thing. So yeah, September 25th, like I said, I'll catch you guys later. Maybe one or two more update videos for the vet before the track day, but that should be really about it. Super stoked. Take it easy, guys. Hopefully I see maybe some of you guys there on that track day. If not, no worries, because I'm going to have a fucking blast. Take it easy, guys. Peace.